Steve Dotto here, and today's topic I'm really excited about, mind mapping. We've all done it, usually in a collaborative environment. Mind mapping is when we take our ideas and we put them into a document of some sort, usually on a whiteboard, where we take a project or a process that we're working on with several other people, and we write it all down with felt markers, and we create connections and milestones and key features or key things that have to happen. That document is called a mind map. It's basically a visual representation of our ideas or of our processes. Now, there are some tremendous software tools that will help us create really elaborate mind maps and allow us to interconnect those mind maps with our other productivity tools. One I've used for many years is MindManager from the Mindjet folks. It has gone through many iterations. It's now a software for a service application, which you pay a monthly subscription fee, and they have cloud-based storage of all of your maps. I'm going to show you that in a few moments. Another one that's available online is this one called MindMeister, which I've been playing with a little bit. I'm not quite as familiar with, but it looks like a tremendous service as well. Now, both of these applications you can use on your desktop, but you can also use on your mobility devices, store all of your different mind maps in the cloud. So they're very much a Web 2.0 type application. Let me show you how MindJet works. And actually, what I'll do is I'll start with a new document. I'll go from a template at this point. Basically, they've got a whole series of different templates in MindManager that allow you to choose a rough structure. And it gives you an idea of the sorts of things that you can do. We've got organizational charts and project timelines and status reports. So they've got all sorts of different type of projects already kind of roughed out for you, so you can see all of the key areas. And going through these different templates will give you a really good understanding of what you can do with an application like MindManager. You have communication ones, you've got strategy sessions, so you can use any of these different templates to create a mind map. If you don't want to, you can just start with a blank one and choose that, and you've got simplicity is the name of the game here. You just type in your central topic of your project. And then what happens is you create links between this central project and the different things, the different ideas that have to happen. And you can use the tools here in the menu bar to insert. You'll very quickly develop skills using all of the different keyboard shortcuts in this. But basically what we're going to do is we're going to create a subtopic for this, which now you see creates a little relationship. And then you put in the information of what your second topic is going to be all about, and you basically start to create some structure here. Let me show you a map that I've already started on. I do a little bit of publicity work for a local theater company, and did I not close that properly? Don't save. There we go. And what I've thought I might do is I'm put together this little mind map which walks us through the publicity process, so I can tell each of the different production managers for each of the plays that comes through this little theater what we do and what the schedule is for different things that have to be done in order for us to properly publicize their production. And this is a great example. This is something that's a dynamic document that I can refer to and I can build on and I can create resources within. And so it just ends up being a real benefit to both myself and to the different productions that come along. And if we take a look over here on the side, you see I've got an area where I have to have all the photos taken. I've got publicity photos that have to be taken, and then dress rehearsals that have to be taken. I've got what happens on the website with the audition announcement, and then the publicity photos have to be put up on the website, and then the newsletter has to go out. So I've got all of this different process. Now, some of these things have to relate to each other. So for example, publicity photos, they have to be taken very early in the process so that we can use them. So I can actually, by right-clicking my mouse here, create and insert a calendar event for when the publicity photos have to be taken. So watch what happens when I do that. Up comes a little dialog box that says, what is the event title? I'm going to say photo shoot. And I'm going to put it in at the theater. Okay, that's Canadian theater, of course, RE. And then I can add different notes, and I'm actually going to make that for today so I can show you some other cool features of the software. Once I say okay, now this becomes an item that has to be done. And you see there's a little bit of a call out here. You can also notice here on my Mac that I've got a new appointment in my calendar, because indeed this connects directly with our calendar app, and that photo shoot has been brought in and made an event within my calendar. And that's what I'm talking about as far as interactivity goes between your different productivity apps and an application like MindManager. It talks to our calendar, to our email, to our contact list to allow us to basically leverage all of those different assets as we create these different projects. Now, that is one of the things that you'll do a lot. Now, you can minimize this window so you don't see it. If you need details, you click the plus sign and you can see all the details. So you can view the map as the map gets more and more elaborate. You're only going to want the main topics to be shown. So you've got nice control over the view. The other thing that you do a lot is you create linkages between things. For example, if we stay within this idea here, once those publicity photos are taken, they have to be put in to the website. So I can actually click here on the publicity photos. If I right click my mouse, I can create a relationship between this item, the publicity photos, and so I'll click here, and the photos that have to go in to the website. So visually looking at this mind map now, anybody who's just looking at it can see, oh, once the publicity photos are taken, they have to go over here. So we can see the relationships building up. Now, as I say, this works tremendously well just building out projects. You can do it individually. You can do it collaboratively with others. There's a huge variety of different tools that I haven't even begun to delve into where you can add notes, you can add hyperlinks, you can add video, you can use the mind map, you can take different elements on the mind map and export it into slides. You can use it as a slideshow and as a presentation to explain your idea to others. You can use mind maps to, you can use them as the basis for a timeline for project management. So you've got lots of different ways this becomes the base for all of your projects. Now, I did mention that this also works in the mobility world. And here's one of the things that I really like about this. Once I've saved this map, I'm just going to save it right now. I can take this map and I can, if I'm out in the field, if I'm at the meeting and I've got my iPad, I can access the same map on my iPad. And let me show you that right now. Okay, I've got my iPad displaying here now, and I want to go into the Mindjet MindManager app, which I have downloaded onto my iPad. Also available Android, also available on your iPhone. It is a free download, which when we put it onto our device, we rely on the cloud storage to be able to access all of the maps. So I'm going to go here into the storage area. I'm going to go into my account. And there are the different maps that I've been working on. There's the publicity map that we were just working on. And there I can see it on my iPad. Now I can actually check this out, which is a fairly cool process, which means that I now have editing control and I can edit it on the iPad if I choose. I don't really love editing these maps on the iPad because I find the tools are just that much more robust on the desktop computer. So I'm much better at editing them on the computer. But the beautiful thing of using a mind map on your mobility device is it is a map. So if you're sitting in a meeting, if you're going through the process, you can open it up and use it just as the map where you can go through and you can say, oh, what do we have to do here? Who has to be responsible for this or the other thing? And as I'm working through the information with the different people on the production team, I've got all of my resources here and available to me, and I don't have to say, oh, it's in this document, it's in that document. I don't have to work my way through it in that way. All of the different key information is available here on my mobility device. Now, the last thing that I want to talk to you about today is the pricing, and let us jump in and take a look at how much it costs for these apps. The folks at Mindjet have two different models. They have a web only version, which is $15 a month, and their full desktop version is available for $30 a month. And you can see all of the different features, the differences between the web and the desktop features. To be honest, I think you just want the desktop version. I mean, you want the desktop, the full version of this. If you're going to use this tool, you're going to use it to its fullest extent. And the desktop version is definitely what you need. As I mentioned, it's available also for free download in for the iPad and for the iPhone. Now, as far as competition is concerned, the MindMeister app that I have been playing with is completely web-based. It's much more of it's a little lighter as far as its feature set, but still pretty darn good. And it's available for as little as $5 a month or $10 a month up to $15 a month for business accounts. And it is also available on the iPad and in other platforms such as Android as well. I find mind mapping to be a creative process. When I sit down and I've got a new project facing me, the way that I approach the very first stages trying to create a representation in my mind of what this project might look like is I create a mind map. It gives me inspiration. It allows me to retain things and remember different items as I create them so that I don't worry that they're lost and they're not written down in a variety of different places. And ultimately, it gives me a roadmap to success if indeed that project or that venture is going to be successful. I hope you found this particular video to be useful to you. If you have, why don't you click a like for us? I would like it if you liked our video. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for spending time with us today.